Yesterday's suicide bomb attacks occurred 3 minutes apart of each other, with two suicide bombers on motorbikes disguising as local border border. Police yesterday confirmed 6 deaths and 33 injuries.
Outside the suicide bomb attackers at Parliamentary Avenue, at least we are confirming that there's an extra body, which we believe is for a civilian. So right now we are still talking about 3 bodies of people that are dead, 3 suicide attackers who killed themselves, and the total so far of the injured persons we rushed to Murago National Referral Hospital has increased up to 33. So far 33 are injured and 5 are critically injured.
Dr. Baterana Byarugaba, the executive director of Mulago National Referral Hospital, today revealed that another person died last night, bringing the number to 7.
As Mulago National Referral Hospital, yesterday 35 patients were received. Of the 35 patients received, 27 were males and 8 were females. Unfortunately, due to God's power, one of our patients, a male, succumbed to injuries yesterday, died.
Dr. Betarana further disclosed that 21 of the victims are ready to be discharged from the hospital, 13 are still hospitalized, and 2 are still in critical conditions.
21 of these 34 are going to be discharged today, meaning that their injuries were relatively minor. So they're going to be discharged today. Of the 21 who are going to be discharged today, it means out of 34, 21 is being discharged, so we remain with 13. So 13 patients will remain on the ward, various wards. And of these 13 patients remaining on various wards, 2 of them are critically sick, so they are admitted in ICU.
Baterana further explains the nature of injuries obtained by most of the victims.
These patients had various injuries. It's not one that you can say this injury or that. These are soft tissue injuries. Whatever the cause, there were soft tissue injuries, and others who had deeper injuries.
Meanwhile, it was a somber mood at Kampala City Mortuary in Mulago as several people turned up to claim for the remains of their relatives who died in yesterday's bomb attacks. Among the deceased is a one Christopher Sande, whose body remains were handed over to the relatives. Other bodies are yet to be claimed for. Dr. Moses Byaruhanga, the police pathologist, revealed that a team of 4 pathologists have already conducted postmortems on the remains.
We've finished our work. It was a team of 4 pathologists. We started early morning, and now they're in the process of embalming, that is, treating the bodies. And thereafter, we shall keep them in the fridge as we wait for people to come and claim for them.
Byaruhanga also revealed that among the bodies handled is that of a suspected suicide bomber who was killed by security agencies in Katoke, Nansana, before he executed a bomb attack. A police officer identified as Constable Amos Kungu has also been identified as one of the deceased.
Among these 4 adult males, one was the body that was involved in the Katoke incident, which was being reported about. Then the 3, one of them was picked from the Parliamentary Avenue. Then the other 2 came from CPS. And among those 2, one of them is a police officer. Yes. Then the other zombie is suspected to be of a suicide bomb.
According to President Museveni's message on his official Twitter handle yesterday, the attackers were identified as Mansoul Uthman, who bombed the CPS entrance, and the one of the IGG office was identified as Wanjusi Abdallah. Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.